Ever wondered how fast lava actually moves? Can it outrun you? Well, that depends on a few mind-blowing factors. Stick around because today, we're breaking down the crazy science behind lava flows. From slow-moving molten rivers to high-speed lava racing down mountains at 30 kilometers per hour, 19 miles per hour. What are lava flows? Lava flows are streams of molten rock that pour or ooze from a volcanic eruption. Depending on the type of eruption, lava can either flow smoothly like syrup or explode violently into the air before cascading down the slopes. The way it moves depends on four key things: one, lava type, and viscosity. Some lava is thin and runny, while others are thick and sluggish. Two, slope steepness. The steeper the ground, the faster lava can travel. 3. Flow path. Whether it spreads out in a wide sheet, moves through a narrow channel, or travels in a hidden lava tube. 4. Eruption intensity. The more lava a volcano pumps out, the faster it can flow. How fast can lava really go? Lava speed varies wildly. Let's break it down. Basalt lava, fastest flowing lava. This is the type of lava you see in Hawaii, like the legendary Kalapana lava flow. On steep slopes, it can move at 10 kilometers per hour, 6 miles per hour. That's faster than most people can run. But if it's confined within a lava tube or a narrow channel, it can hit insane speeds of 30 kilometers per hour, 19 miles per hour. Andesite lava, medium speed, moves at just a few kilometers per hour, a couple of feet per second. Rarely travels beyond 8 kilometers, 5 miles, from the volcano. Dacite and rhyolite lava, the slow giants. These create lava domes, massive steep-sided mounds that grow super slowly. They move at just a few meters per hour and can take months or even years to fully form. One of the most famous lava flows in history was in Kalapana, Hawaii, where molten rock swallowed buildings, roads, and even a lagoon within a month. This unstoppable force reminds us just how powerful nature can be.
Thank you.
28th January, 2017, Kilauea Volcano. The open lava stream continues at the Kamakuna ocean entry. The stream is remarkably steady, but produced pulsating littoral explosions where the lava impacted the water. How hot is lava? Now, let's talk about the insane heat of lava. It's literally hotter than fire and can melt just about anything. Basalt lava, 1,100 to 1,250 degrees Celsius. Andesite lava, 800 to 1,000 degrees Celsius. Dacite and rhyolite lava, 650 to 780 degrees Celsius. 800 degrees Celsius. What does that mean for everyday objects? Let's compare. Wood burns at 300 degrees Celsius. Lava turns it to ash instantly. Plastic melts at 100 to 250 degrees Celsius. Lava completely vaporizes it. Aluminum melts at 660 degrees Celsius. Lava melts aluminum like butter. Iron melts at 1,500 degrees Celsius. Basalt lava gets close, but wouldn't fully melt iron unless left in direct contact. And if human skin touched lava, the heat would instantly cause third-degree burns before even making direct contact, as the radiant heat alone is enough to scorch flesh from several feet away. you outrun lava? Well, it depends. If it's slow-moving dacite, you're probably safe. But if it's basalt lava speeding down a steep slope, good luck. If you found this video fascinating, hit that like button and subscribe for more insane natural phenomena.